Welcome to your English class. Hope you all are doing great and doing well at your places. So last time, in the last lecture, we were discussing about lesson 3, discovering third, the Sagar continuous. I had sent you a few videos also. I just hope that you all have gone through those videos. And now the basic concept of this chapter is clear to you. Fine. So today we will continue with this chapter. So first let us just recapitulate the things. In the first part, first and second part, we had read about the mystery of this pharaoh, Tutankhaten, that is King Tut, he is dearly known as. He was the youngest pharaoh who died mysteriously. The reason of the death is not confirmed yet. After 3300 years of his burial, his tomb was discovered first by Howard Carter in 1922. He was a British archaeologist. And later on, after 80 years, why Tut's mummy is so important? Why we are reading this chapter? Because it was the first mummy which had undergone CT scan. Just to know his physical appearance and the reason of his death, his mummy was the very first dead body who had undergone for the CT scan. So that was the reason why it is important. Another thing was that he was the last year of this pharaoh dynasty, and he was the last king, and after that the whole dynasty was totally vanished. So I will be starting from page number 25. In the last paragraph, today we will read about his family history, about family chart, how it all started and what happened, what small information we have during that period we will be just discussing in this chapter. I hope you all are carrying your books. Please open your books at page number 25. Before that, if you remember, we had discussed that in his burial, in his tomb, there was a three-layered casket of gold that was gilded with pure gold, and so many expensive artifacts and other daily use items were also buried with King Tut, just to help him, just so that he can carry that riches to the afterlife also, because Egyptians, they believe that there is life after death. So he was the king of the richest dynasty, so many expensive items were also buried along with his grave, tomb, you can say, the coffin. Fine, so page number 25, we will discuss now Amenhotep. I have given you here the tree here, you can just see here and you can look into your books also. Amenhotep III, he was the father or grandfather, that is not confirmed yet. He was the ruler of that pharaoh dynasty for 40 long years. He ruled over there for 40 long years. And then he was succeeded by Amenhotep IV. Now he was the person who promoted the worship of Aten. Aten was the sun, the god of the sun, god or the son of disk and the sun disk. And he changed, even he was so much into this worship of sun god that he changed his name to Akhenaten. He changed his name to Akhenaten. And what were the reasons behind that? We will just read about that. So Amenhotep III, he was Tut's father or grandfather, was a powerful pharaoh who ruled for almost four decades at the height of the 18th dynasty's golden age. His son Amenhotep IV succeeded him and initiated one of the strangest periods in the history of ancient Egypt. The new pharaoh promoted the worship of the Aten, the sun disk, which I told you, and he was so much into this worship that he erected very, very huge temples and worship places of this Aten at various places, and he ordered each and every person in his reign, they will follow his orders and they will worship only and only the sun disk. And he changed his name to Akhenaten, or servant of the Aten, and moved the religious capital from the old city of Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten, known now as Amarna. Now this city is known as Amarna, where he shifted from Thebes to Akhenaten, just for this worship of God. He further shocked the country by attacking Amun, a major god, smashing his images and closing his temples. nobody will worship Amun and everybody is going to worship Etel only. It must have been a horrific time, said Ray Johnson, director of the University of Chicago's Research Center in Luxor, the site of ancient Thebes. The family that had ruled for centuries was coming to an end, and then Akhenaten went a little wacky. He became a kind of finicky person, you can say, wacky ho gaya. He was totally out of people that you should follow my rules, this and that. After Akhenaten's death, a mysterious ruler named Smikir appeared briefly and exited without hardly a trace. After this, Akhenaten, when he died, there was one more ruler, one more king. His name was Smikir, but he did not exist. He did not exist for a very long time, and he just passed away without any trace in the history. And then a very young Tutankhaten took the regime. Now, what we are talking about, King Tut. Then he had taken over from him. King Tut, as he is widely known today, the boy king soon changed his name to Tutankhamun, living image of Amun. Again, he started worship of Amun. Akhenaten was worshipping God. This you have to keep in mind. Akhenaten, or first he was Amenhotep. Amenhotep, he started worshipping Amun, and that's where he became Akhenaten. He started worshipping Aten, and he became Akhenaten. After his death, when Tutankhamun came, he just changed his name to Tutankhamun. He started worshipping God Amun again, and oversaw restoration of the old ways. जैसे पुराने ज़माने में पूजा होती थी, उसने दोबारा से उसकी मंदिर वगैरह बनाने start कर दिए. He reigned for about 9 years and then died unexpectedly. For only 9 years he was there, the king, and he died unexpectedly, and his death is a mystery till date. Nobody knows the reason. With the videos that I had sent you, there are some speculations about his death. If you would have seen them, many people speculate that he must have died by doing the horse riding, because there was a clot in his skull, but the reason is still not clear, so we cannot just come to any conclusion. So regardless of his fame and the speculations about his fate, that is one mummy among many in Egypt. How many? No one knows. There are so many, the valley of kings, as I told you. All the kings and the queens, they are buried over there. So nobody knows how many graves, tombs are there. Howard Carter, he was totally into this thing. He just wanted to know that the reason of this Pharaoh dynasty's end. That's why he just went for this guts room, and he was lucky enough that after so much effort, he was able to discover the tomb of King Tut. The Egyptian mummy project, which began an inventory in late 2003, has recorded almost 600 or so far and is still counting. In 2003, they started with this project to just excavate the tombs of all these princely people, and till date they have 600 they have discovered, and still the number is counting. The next phase is scanning the mummies with a portable CT machine donated by the National Geographic Society and Siemens, its manufacturer. King Tut is one of the first mummies to be scanned, which I told you earlier, and the Siemens company, they had donated this CT scanner, portable CT scanner. Otherwise, CT scanning is a very huge and very complicated machinery. But for this purpose, because they could not take that mummy to the outside that specified area because of the curse or the rituals, you can say that doesn't allow. So Siemens company, they had made a specified portable CT scan machine for this purpose. A CT machine scanned the mummy head to toe, creating 1700 digital X-ray images in cross section. Tut's head scan in 0.62 millimeter, very intricate details were found out just to make a 3D image of that pharaoh, just how he looked. So that is the benefit, you can say, of this technology, that they were able to at least put that mummy into that 3D dimension, so that we now the pictures which we see, the pictures you must have seen in the videos also, or wherever it is available, So it is just just they have this faith, the Egyptian people, that there is angels who are guiding those tomb, and they took away that from under the, what we say, the care of those angels. That tomb was discovered and it was taken out for the CT scan. The night of the scan, workmen carried Tut from the tomb in his box like pallbearers. They climbed a ramp and a flight of stairs into a swirling sand outside, then rose on a hydraulic lift into the trailer. Now what happened? Actually, that night when it was proposed that today the CT scan will be done, what happened that night? The pallbearers, the palki khate hain, they just lifted it up and they just went. There was a big truck, a big hydraulic machine was there where the CT scan machine was installed. So they just went there. They put that mummy into that truck, and the CT scan, the process was initiated. But again, what happened? The machinery is very delicate, you know, and as I told you, the moment when they started this operation, very, very strong wind started blowing. So some of our speculating, it was the Pharaoh's curse that they have disturbed their tumor, whatsoever. They were the superstitions, just it was just the weather which was getting worse. So the fans, they just stopped working. The CT scan machine's fans, they stopped working. And soon both of the workers, they were just going around, and they just took some portable fans, they put it there, and then only the work was completed. Eventually the substitute fans worked well enough to finish the procedure, and they worked well. Now after checking that no data had been lost, the technicians turned Tut over to the workmen, who carried him back to his tomb less than 3 hours after he was removed from his coffin. The Pharaoh again rested in peace where the funerary priest had laid him for so long. And it took them 3 hours to just CT scan the body. And after 3 hours, when everything was done, all the details were taken, all the images were clicked, and then he was put to rest from where they had taken him away. Fine, up to this point. Now back in the trailer, a technician pulled up astonishing images of Tut on a computer screen. A grey head took shape from a scattering of pixels, and the technician spun and tilted it in every direction. Neck vertebrae appeared as clearly as in an anatomy class. Now whole procedure, now that is the benefit, that is the, what you said, the technology that is meant for that only. The whole picture, like a three-dimensional picture, I told you that using those slices which they had clicked, they had put those slices all together, and a 3D picture was clicked, 3D picture was prepared of a King Tut. Now after that, other images revealed a hand, several views of the rib cage, and a transection of the skull. But for now the pressure was off, now everything went smooth. Zahi Hawass, he took a sigh of relief that everything went smooth, nothing happened, nothing, any accident did not happen, had gone seriously wrong. I didn't sleep last night, not for a second, he said. I was so worried, but now I think I will go and sleep, he said. Now by the time we left the trailer descending metal stairs to the sandy ground, the wind had stopped, and when everything was done, if this procedure was completed, the wind also stopped blowing. The winter air lay cold and still like death itself in this valley in the departed. Just above the entrance to Tut's tomb stood Orion. Now this is a constellation all of you must be knowing. Orion was there on the entrance of that tomb. The constellation that ancient Egyptians knew as the soul of Isis, the god of afterlife. And as Egyptians they believe, because that is the god of afterlife, and he was there watching the body of King Tut. His mummy was again lying there in the same position where he was laid to peace after his death. So the chapter finishes here. So in this chapter we just came to know about the first incident, the very first procedure of CT scanning of the world's first mummy, that was of King Tutankhaten, and fondly known as King Tut. I just hope you have understood the chapter, class 11. A bit different chapter this is. It is very interesting. Those who are interested in history or the archaeology, it is very interesting chapter. Just to get to know, 33 So till then, take care of yourself. God bless you all. Thank you.